resting. He's very tired. Sing needs to rest. And she even went to Congress and was like, hey, no big deal. I'm giving him everything you're saying, Congress. I'm giving him all the letters and the things. So, what do you guys think of this or law or thing that we're working on? And they'd be like, whatever, we think good. And then she'd bring it to Woodrow, who was like half awake. She'd be like, all right, well, Congress is like, blah, blah, blah. And he'd be like, And she was like, well, I guess I'll compromise. I'm just gonna make the decision. Make the decision myself. So basically, Edith Wilson was first female president. She ran memos between Congress and him. Congress is like, all right, what? What? What is going on? So Congress picked this one Republican senator, Albert Fall. They're like, Albert, come see what his true condition is. Come see what Wilson's true condition is. So Albert Fall shows up. He's like, can we come in and see the true condition? She's not stupid. She's like, yeah, sure, come on in. So Albert Fall comes in. Him that I don't understand because I'm just some dumb broad, and Edith just propped up Woodrow in bed, like waving, like, hey, and they're like, oh, okay, cool. And she's like, bye, and then they leave. That's how dumb government is.
Elvis writes a letter to Nixon while on the plane. They land, and he drops it off in front of the White House. It was shocking. No celebrities want to hang out with Nixon. So when he reached out, they're like, Elvis wants to meet. This can't hurt matters. Don't you want to see what Elvis has to say? Why not? He's like, yeah, Ranger. Yeah, I'm gonna see what's going on. And Elvis comes in, and Nixon looks at me like, this is crazy, man. You're really crazy, man. Hey, you have your get up by now. Okay. Nixon's like, yeah. But I'm glad you came by. I want to meet you. Good to see you. And Elvis does a hard sell, saying he needs the badge. I don't care, man. I care about what's going on with these people. I don't care about the hippies. Everything's being said right now, man. It's terrifying. People are saying things about you. And people are saying things about me. And that's why I'm happy to be here. Man. But I need this badge. This is so big for me. I need it. Nixon really takes it in, kind of asks his aide. He's like, can we do this? And the aide comes back and says, I'm sorry, it's done. Can I get this badge? Sorry, Mr. Presley, you cannot. You have no qualifications in our mind to have this badge. Sorry, brother. I'm loving it. And Nixon decides to give him this badge. So Elvis goes back to the photos taken, but then Elvis is a licensed and registered federal narcotics agent.
So he was like, oh shit, this is crazy, but probably won't affect me. I'm an American citizen. I've been here all my life. And then a couple months national twice in the same sentence. Excuse me. Therefore, we must put them, round them up, and put them in internment camps because they're too dangerous. So why don't we meet and figure out what to do about this? And then the government was like, we need more troops. We're going to start drafting Japanese Americans to fight in the war.